thermal conductivity of composite bars when bars are in parallel. So consider two bars. Both are having equal length, but those are having different cross-sectional area, A1 and A2. Hence, heat energy of the both blocks or bars will be different. And then thermal conductivity also varies. So resistance R equal to L by KA. Consider the effective resistance is nothing but R equal to L by KA. There is no change in L, only change in area. So 1 by R equal to KA by L. Similarly, 1 by R1 equal to K1 A1 L and 1 by R2 equal to K2 A2 by L. Since L is same, only area of cross section only different, and the thermal conductivity also different. We know that thermal resistors in series, the effective reciprocal of the effective resistor, thermal resistor, is equal to reciprocal sum of the reciprocal of individual resistances, thermal resistance. So 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. If we substitute all these three, we can get KA. Here A is nothing but A1 plus A2. And Q, net heat energy, Q equal to Q1 plus Q2. So K instead of A, greater than A1 plus A2 by L equal to, remember equal to K1 A1 by L plus K2 A2 by L. So K of A1 plus A2 into 1 by L equal to 1 by L. We take now outside 1 by L. So K1 A1 plus K2 A2. 1 by L, 1 by L cancel. So K of A1 plus A2 equal to K1 A1 plus K2 A2. If both are having same area cross section, that is A1 equal to A2, then K A1 plus A1 2A1 equal to K1 A1 plus K2 A1. So 2K into A1 equal to, you can take it outside the A1 of K1 plus A2. A1 you cancel. So 2K equal to K1 plus K2, or the effective thermal conductivity K equal to K1 plus K2 by, in case given the values, area of cross section and the thermal conductivity of the both bars, if the effective thermal conductivity asked, if we simply add and divide by 2, we can make it the value of effective thermal conductivity. Thermal conductivity of composite bars when bars are in parallel. So consider two bars. Both are having equal length, but those are having different cross-sectional area, A1 and A2. Hence, heat energy of the both blocks or bars will be different. And then thermal conductivity also varies. So resistance R equal to L by KA. Consider the effective resistance is nothing but R equal to L by KA. There is no change in L, only change in area. So 1 by R equal to KA by L. Similarly, 1 by R1 equal to A1 L, and 1 by R2 equal to K2 A2 by L. Since L is same, only area of cross section only different, and the thermal conductivity also different. We know that thermal resistors in series, the effective reciprocal of the effective resistor, thermal resistor, is equal to sum of the reciprocal of individual resistances, thermal resistances. So 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. If we substitute all these three, we can get KA. Here A is nothing but A1 plus A2. And Q net heat energy, Q equal to Q1 plus Q2. So K instead of A greater than A1 plus A2 by L equal to 1 by R1 equal to K1 A1 by L plus K2 A2 by L. So K of A1 plus A2 into 1 by L equal to 1 by L. It taken outside 1 by L. So K1 A1 plus K2 A2. 1 by L, 1 by L cancel. So K of A1 plus A2 equal to K1 A1 plus K2 A2. If both are having same area of cross section, that is A1 equal to A2, then K1 plus A1 2 A1 equal to K1 A1 plus K2 A1. So 2K into A1 equal to, you can take it outside the A1 of K1 plus A2. A1 you cancel. So 2K equal to K1 plus K2, or the effective thermal conductivity K equal to K1 plus K2 by, in case given the values, area of cross section and the thermal conductivity of the both bars, if the effective thermal conductivity asked, if we simply add and divide by 2, we can get the value of effective thermal conductivity.